Sometimes your animal shows excessive tears, rubs his eye, and tries to avoid the light. Then you ask yourself, why my dog or cat is rubbing his eye? What is the problem and what should I do? You have to know that the cornea is a transparent tissue that forms the anterior part of the outer fibrous protective layer of the eye. And it neither has blood vessels nor pigments, but it has lot of nerve endings. And this explains the pain we feel when we accidentally touch our cornea. Rubbing of the eye, evifora or excessive tears, photophobia, avoiding the light, and blepharospasm, spastic closure of the two eyelids, may indicate that your animal has corneal ulcer. What's corneal ulcer? Simply it means that part of the corneal thickness is lost. What will happen when my dog or cat affected with corneal ulceration? Corneal ulceration is a special type of corneal inflammation, keratitis. When it affects your animal, both of the normal corneal characteristic features and animal behavior will change. You will notice that your animal has light sensitivity. The dog or the cat will try to avoid light and will close his eye. It is called blepharospasm. And we will notice signs of discomfort, like rubbing of the eye. You can see excessive ocular discharge that starts cirrus, evifora or excessive tear formation. But with the time, it starts to change into purulent greenish or yellowish discharge as a result of bacterial infection. And it will dry to form crusts over the eye. Redness of the eye as a result of conjunctival injection, and the cornea loses its luster and transparency. It acquires dirty glass appearance. There will be invasion of the corneal periphery by short blood vessels forming a red ring at the periphery of the cornea at the limbar region. And there will be loss of the corneal tissue in the form of decreased thickness of the cornea in some areas. How veterinarians diagnose corneal ulcer? Not all corneal ulcers are large enough to be seen. Some are tiny and superficial and require sort of magnification to be detected. And sometimes they use special stains like fluorescein to stain the ulcer and to make it clear to be visualized.
How can you treat eye infection of your dog or cat without going to the veterinarian? Actually, it will be the biggest mistake you ever do.
Yes, it is true that the usual treatment of the ulcer include using topical antibiotic and steroids. But the veterinarian is the only well-qualified one who can say when to use cortisone. Cortisone as anti-inflammatory shouldn't be used while the ulcer exists, and its use before epithelialization of the ulcer will aggravate the case and may lead to corneal perforation. Cortisone can be used in certain stages of corneal ulceration to reduce the amount of fibrous connective tissue that will be formed during healing process and subsequently reduces the scar formation. Only the veterinarian knows the importance of atropine eye drops for treatment of corneal ulcer and deep keratitis and how it works. Atropine is a mydriatic cycloplegic drug. It acts by induction of mydriasis, dilatation of the pupil, and relaxation of ciliary body's muscle. Cycloplegia. Mydriasis lowers the possibility of synechiae, the anterior or posterior adhesion of the inflamed iris to the inflamed cornea anteriorly or to the lens posteriorly, or adhesion between two quadrants of the pupil with subsequent block of visual axis and permanent loss of vision. Atropine also helps to relieve pain in the eye by relaxing the muscles of the ciliary body. The choice of the suitable antibiotic may require antibiotic sensitivity test. And your typical use of antibiotics without asking your veterinarian will act as an obstacle on the road of proper treatment. Moreover, corneal ulcer is a complex disease that may require surgical intervention for supporting the cornea either by conjunctival flap or third eyelid flap. What I have to do if I think that my animal has corneal ulcer? Just wash the eye with sterile warm normal saline. Cover it with a sterile eye cover and contact your veterinarian. Never try to use topical eye drops without consulting your veterinarian. And don't try to treat the animal by yourself.